Yes guys, my name is Morsi and welcome back to my channel. It is so damn early in the morning guys, I'm absolutely shattered but I do have a cup of coffee to support me in today's video. I was up late last night selling my soul to the squad battle gods, all to unlock one player for a video today. He's the second elite objective alongside Isaac, it's the big man, the big midfield bruiser, William Carvalho. So boys, what are we thinking of the La Liga team this season so far? Are you a fan? Personally, I think it's better than the Premier League team this season. The objective players are so much better. Both of them look super usable. If you've not seen the video I posted yesterday on Isaac himself, he's a top tier card. And I'm hoping William Carvalho follows suit. But to unlock this chap, you're more than likely going to have to play a bit of squad battles, guys. And I don't know about you boys, but squad battles can take its toll on you mentally. Assist 10 goals with free balls in squad battles on min professional difficulty. You can also do this on rivals, but I would recommend squad battles because it is a little bit more chilled out, I guess. And you're not guaranteed to get all these objectives done game by game. With squad battles, there is literally a 10 game maximum. You can get everything done in 10 matches, so that's probably what I'd recommend. Assist with a CDM in 3 separate squad battle matches on world class difficulty. Score using La Liga players in 6 separate squad battle wins on world class. And then score using Portuguese players in 10 separate squad battle matches on min professional difficulty. So what I did is I played the first 6 matches on world class. Then you can go down to professional for the last 4 guys just to ride it out. And then you get yourself a William Carvalho. So Big Willy is 6'2", medium, 3-star skills and 4-star weak foot. And these are the stats that he's working with. Straight away, 99 attack positioning and 99 shot power is a little bit insane. He's a CDM and I'm pretty confident I'm going to play him smack bang in that middle of the CDM role. So to have the option to go forward and maybe have a shot on goal and potentially score, yeah, we'll take it. It's a bonus. The 99 shot power and the 90 long shots are a nice little trait to ping them from outside the box. We shall be trying that in today's video. The pace is a little bit on the low side. Same with the agility and balance. So it's kind of against the meta, I guess. But with an engine, you do boost it up a little bit. You get 84 acceleration, 91 sprint speed, 86 agility and 92 balance. So it isn't actually that bad in all fairness. Defensive stats are awesome. 91 interception, 94 defensive awareness. The rest of the defending stats are mid to high 80s. The physicals, of course, he's there. This guy is an absolute brick shithouse. 96 strength, 86 stamina, 83 aggression. The jumping's a little bit on the low side, but we don't really care about that, do we, boys? Passing stats look good to me. 91 short pass, 89 long pass. That's jacked up with the engine chem. And the curve and vision look pretty solid. The crossing's on the low side, but as your CDM, you probably shouldn't be whipping him down the wing and pinging balls in left, right, and centre. Player traits, he's got long passer CPU AI and playmaker CPU AI. So, William Carvalho, the aim of today's video is to see if he is worth the grind, guys. 10 squad battle matches takes a little while. You know, it takes at least 3+ hours. Similar with the Patty Bamford video we did last week with that objective. So we're going to test him out of Div 1 and see if he is worth it. He also fits in super nicely into my team, into the team that I used for the Isaac player review. There's the man, by the way. I used him for the squad battles. Okay, that's why his goal to game ratio is absolutely insane. But look, 6'4", high low, 4-star, 5-star. And stats like that. But this may end up being the team that I use for foot champs this weekend. I was actually using a bit of Mason Mount for the first few games. And guys, he's actually really good. You know, he's a lot better than what I thought he was going to be in game. The 3-star skill is a little bit of a letdown, as I like a 4-star skill player. But going forward, the acceleration is insane. The shooting is insane. The passing stats are pretty much maxed out. Same with the dribbling. Like, really, really good card. And I would recommend him if you could fit him into a Prem team, guys. Custom tactics haven't changed from my previous videos. We're rocking the balance, 5 width, and 6 depth. In regards to the formation, it's the big 4-4-2 brackets 2. And there he is, William Carvalho, smack bang in the middle alongside the bruiser and Ndombele. Mbappe and Isaac up top, Bestie and Nkunku either side. The back 4 stays the same, boys. We're using centre-backs as centre-back. Do I get bonus points for that? I hope I do. Because every team I'm probably going to play in today's video is going to have about 5 right-backs across the back line. So what I'm going to do, lads, is hop into some Div 1 matches. It is currently 6:20 in the morning, so I'm not playing any foot champs. I'll lose my sanity. It'll be out the window completely. So we're going to have some nice, relaxing 2100 skill total Div 1 games. Test out William Carvalho. I'm going to compile all the clips into our montage for you boys. And you know the drill. Catch up with you afterwards. bruiser, Big William. 2 goals in 3 matches, 0 assists. And the first thing I would say about this card, the height is perfect. He's not too tall, he's not too small for a CDM. I didn't notice the pace being too much lackluster. He was able to track the play, intercept balls quite easily. The agility and balance, it was decent for a CDM, in all fairness. Now we get into the stage where team of the seasons are jacked up and their agility, balance, and jumping stats are insane for a CDM. But this guy has a solid card, guys. Don't overlook him, honestly. He's really, really good. Going forward, he got the goals. He got 2 goals. One of them was an open goal. I don't know what my opponent was doing. His head was out the window. Probably lost the game of foot champs recently. The defensive stats are brilliant. Interceptions are really, really good. And getting him, like, intercepting runs with this guy, it's so hard for players to get past. They've got such a big frame that they just bounce off him. He keeps the ball, shielding the ball. He's a tank. He's literally a tank. And with the La Liga team this season being as insane as it is, guys, get him in your team. Why not? If you have the option to get a CDM from the La Liga, don't look much further than William Carvalho. He's technically free to do, and he's an absolute unit. Rating-wise, I'm going to give him an 8.5 out of 10, purely for the fact that squad battles is involved and I don't like squad battles. It's pretty much double to triple the time than doing the online friendlies because you get the rage quits in online friendlies and it goes a lot quicker. Squad battles, they don't rage quit. You imagine if they did, oh mate, EA. Imagine a rule where if you score more than 5 goals, the team quits. That'd be beautiful. Anyway, lads, I'm probably going back to bed now. I hope you enjoyed this video, as always. If you're new around here, please do consider dropping me a subscription. We're pushing to 1,000 subs. Yesterday, I gained about 25 subscribers. It was mental. We are about 50, 60 away for 1K. So if you are new and you enjoy this kind of content, please do consider it. Drop me a like, leave me a comment, let me know what you get up to this weekend, and if you're excited for the La Liga team of the season. And I'll catch you very soon for another video. Take it easy, boys.